cannot leave the water sector for the government alone to do. The private sector must be involved, the developmental partners, the private financiers, multinationals, you and I, and that's why the Federal Ministry of Water Resources saw a reason under the auspices of the federal government to organize this summit. So come along, let's learn from them.
Human beings move from one exciting day into another, powered by life-giving nature, which itself is sustained by some elements. None of these elements is in fact inferior to the other. But in the act and art of survival on planet Earth, the importance of water cannot and will never be played down for 1 minute.
About 70% of our body is water. And that makes me to remember my elementary science. And I remember in those days, our teachers would tell you that the protoplasm, where the biochemical processes take place that control the physiological processes that keep you alive, is over 90% water. And if you lose probably 50% of the water in your protoplasm, I don't think you will be alive. And always remind us that there are two key things that make us alive. One, that food, that the number of people can stay without food for a couple of days. These days, some people even fast for 7 days dry fasting. I don't know how practicable it is. The medical doctors will tell us, but so I've been told. But they say that you can stay without food for a couple of days, but you cannot stay without oxygen for up to 5 minutes. Could be extremely less than that. And one thing again is that you can't stay without water. Because if your protoplasm loses about 50%, not even up to that, the concentration will be so much that, of course, you will die.
Pardon the scientist Nigerian president for taking a break from his ASORoC duties for a brief sojourn back to class, which was his professional habitat. But did he really put aside presidential duties in those short moments of lecture on the main composition of protoplasm? Not if you consider that he was engaging in a preamble to his speech at the opening of an international presidential summit on innovative funding of the water sector in Nigeria, which he was the host of. At that auspicious gathering from February 18 to 19, 2013, in the Nigerian capital Abuja, speaker after speaker extolled the place of aqua vitae, which in rough translation comes out as water of life. It was in every sense an international attention to water, just water.
The subject of water and its funding is an issue whose time for decision and solution is overdue. Thanks, therefore, to the President for organizing this meeting on the issue of innovative funding for water. Why is water so important? We are told that 70% of our body is made up of water.
Nigeria is one of the first countries to complete the formulation of a national agricultural investment program, which we jointly conducted with the Ministry of Agriculture and Water Resources.
In our sub-region of West Africa, many places are still afflicted with water or river blindness, elephantiasis, guinea worm, hookworm, and many other debilitating infections from poor water. Thankfully, in this era of science and technology and mutual global efforts under the leadership of the United Nations organization, humanity has become increasingly aware of the necessity for the right quality of water to drink.
Water is life. Water is health. Water is agriculture. Water is energy. Water is everything.
I want to congratulate Dr. Goodluck Ebele Johnathan the President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria on this very bold initiative to address our water challenges. I equally commend Mrs. Sarah Ochekpe, the Honourable Minister of Water Resources, for choosing the term innovative funding of the water sector in Nigeria.
Water, by traditional definition, is the transparent, colorless liquid that bears the formula H2L and which falls from the sky as rain, issues from the ground as spring, and covers a larger part of the earth's surface in the form of sea, river, lake, and so on, depending on the level. Our woods, associated with this essential commodity of life in our day-to-day living, so life itself practically revolves around water. However, in Nigeria, only 61% of the population has access to good water, while a mere 32% have good sanitation. In her welcome address, the Honourable Minister of Water Resources herself, Sarah Ochekpe, had in her capacity at that occasion welcomed the gathering with a note of emphasis on the priority the Nigerian government has placed on water. It was an occasion that attracted all blessings and backing right from the top. The minister went on to give good grounding to the spirit of the occasion. A wind of change is blowing across Nigeria, and there was no way water would be left out of the transformation agenda of the Johnathan administration.
Therefore, for us in the water sector, our assignment is a divine calling, and we cannot rest on our oars until every citizen had access to safe and potable water for domestic use and other multipurpose uses. And this can only be attained by having all stakeholders, government, that is the federal government, the states and local governments, the development partners, the private sectors and NGOs, working together in a concerted manner and ensuring adequate funding and capacity development beyond annual government funding provisions.
Fine words from the Water Resources Minister, and also ones that the Permanent Secretary in the Ministry, Ambassador Godnoz Igali, relishes, given the background to the entire affair.
We see that there's a deficit between what can come from the public sector funding and the needs. There's a gap, and when the gap exists, either projects are not completed or projects are delayed unduly, and sometimes they're even abandoned, and worse still, our projects are not done at all. So, and these projects are vital. Water is vital. We've been hearing it since yesterday. Water is overarching. Water straddles different sectors: health, education, communication, transportation, human habitation,
even agriculture,
and so on. So for us, we must critically back on water projects, and the money from government is not enough. So we have to think outside the box. We have to think of new paradigms, new ways of doing things. And well, that's how we came up with it. And let us think of how new ways, innovative ways, ways that can create the needed impact. And we discussed with the president. The president personally took over. He said, this is good, let's sit down and talk. So it's more of a conversation on what to do.
The Vice President for Infrastructure, Private Sector and Regional Integration, African Development Bank, ADB, Gilbert Mbeshrubusa, saluted the rising budgetary allocation to water by the Nigerian authorities.
This summit, focusing on innovative funding, is therefore timely and opportune in identifying ways to bridge the huge water infrastructure gap, as well as methods to channel available funding to the most important investment and maintenance needs. It is indeed a very special occasion, bringing together the country's entire political leadership as well as water practitioners to raise awareness of water and sanitation, not primarily as an issue, but rather as a solution to the broader development challenge facing Nigeria today.
While a former water resources minister, Mukta Shagari, expressed the relevance of good health arising from good water to our productive workforce.
One thing we have to be very careful about is that we should understand the larger population of the people that need access to water are poor.
Yeah.
And this is an issue that we have to look at very seriously and very passionately, so that if the private sector is coming in, then there must be proper protection for those people who cannot really afford. I actually think that at the moment what is very important is that there actually should be proper understanding between the state governments, the federal government, local governments, and the donor agencies to ensure that we're giving water to our people. When the time for privatization of water comes, we shall do it. But I believe that at the moment, we should concentrate more on providing water, which is the responsibility of the government of this country, is the responsibility of the state governments, is the responsibility of the local governments, and the communities also should also be made to participate in that, so that they can own this water project when they are provided for them.
For the representative of the Economic Community of West African States, ECOWAS, the Nigerian Initiative on Water would have import and impact on what the sub-region earmarks for the life-saving resource. He expressed the natural support of the ECOWAS Commission to the efforts of the Nigerian government.
This summit will certainly be an inspiration for the other ECOWAS member states to promote investment in the water sector. Excellency, Mr. President, I hope the summit will come up with far-reaching conclusion for greater efforts in mobilizing water resources for the intensification of agriculture in Nigeria that could become the breadbasket of West Africa. To that end, the ECOWAS Commission will strive to ensure its consideration by the agency, the fund and the various financial instruments to be put in place in support of the hardworking Nigerian farmers. More than ever, the work of ECOWAS forms part of a vision to ensure integrated economic development and conflict prevention. Water, therefore, is an important element that needs to be protected. I therefore welcome the Nigerian government initiative of placing this meeting at such a high level.
Two former presidents who robustly spoke at the opening gave the kind of overview you would expect from men who have been at the helm of affairs and made efforts to preserve lives threatened by inadequate infrastructure. Former President of Ghana, John Kufo, and now Chairman of Sanitation and Water, was glib in his acceptance of the fine points of an address by the Nigerian Minister of Finance and Coordinating Minister of the Economy, Ngozi Okonjo-Iweala, at an earlier international conference, while two-time Nigerian President Olusegun Obasanjo said time had come to, as he put it, think out of the box concerning water development.
She therefore urged her colleague ministers to look at how they could better define and prioritize their budgetary expenditure on the water sector. She further pointed out that there was a strong economic argument to invest in water, citing a recent World Bank study of 18 African countries, which showed that together, those countries lost around $5.5 billion every year due to poor sanitation and water alone. On the other hand, for every $1 spent on sanitation and water in the developing countries, the average return was about $5. The point here is that efficient funding and implementation of water projects is an investment that saves large amounts of money for the state and also enhances the health and thereby the productivity of the population.
But whatever it is,
we must admit that business as usual will not get us there. And that is why we are here. The beginning, as I see it, is our water policy in all its ramifications. Is water a political issue? An economic issue? Or a social issue? It is when we are clear on this that we can move sure-footedly forward. Water overarches with many other ministries, but it is so important that it must be a ministry by itself. But for me, water is all the three issues that I mentioned, political, economic, and social, and even more. And for that reason, it is too serious and too important to be left in the hands of politicians alone. Too serious and too important to be left in the hands of the private sector alone. Too serious and too important to be left in the hands of international financial institutions alone. They are here. Too serious and too important to be left in the hands of the civil societies alone. Then where do you leave it? In the hands of all of them. All hands have to be on deck to deal with the issue of water for humanity adequately and sustainably.
For her part, the Finance Minister Ngozi Okonjo-Iweala outlined the huge budgetary commitment the Nigerian government has devoted to water resources over the next 5 years, but warned that partnership in funding water development has become a subject too precious to ignore.
So we have a situation in which we are losing a lot of money and productivity and not able to create wealth because of poor access to water and good sanitation. And at the same time, we have a situation in which it's very lucrative to invest economically in water projects and in sanitation projects. So somewhere we need to bridge that gap. And I think that the gap that we see is the lack of prioritization of funding to the sector. So this is what we need to look at. If we can do that, find international ways of mobilizing money and prioritize the water sector as a primary beneficiary of these resources. This is one way of innovating in terms of directing and channeling resources to that sector. We've not spoken about that yet, but I think that this is an area we cannot let go. Two taxes, international financial transactions tax, and secondly, a tax on airline tickets. They're already ongoing, but many more countries need to join to make this real. Then, of course, the third way and that we've talked about here is getting the private sector involved. I already said that the rate of return to water projects is over 20%. So this should be attractive to private sector people that want to engage through public-private partnerships in these water projects. And we in Nigeria welcome this. As the Minister of Water Resources said, they've already opened up a unit. We also have a unit in the Ministry of Finance designed to support the design of good financial arrangements for investment in these water supply and other sectors.
If water sustains life, lack of it or having it from contaminated sources would pose a big problem to the people's health. The Nigerian Minister of Health, Professor Onyebuchi Chukwu, used the incidence of cholera to illustrate how important water is to the citizens' well-being.
2.5 years ago, 2010, 46,000 cases of cholera. This time round, 1,800 deaths. When I say only, in comparison to 1991 and 1995. So what, in terms of analysis, yes, probably the health sector is intervening in terms of treating cases of cholera better now, but we are not yet preventing cholera. There's no doubt that if we provide water, so many of these diseases should be out of the way in Nigeria. Take, for instance, Guinea worm. What was the strategy in getting Guinea worm out of Nigeria? For 4 years now, we've not had a single case of Guinea worm, simply by providing water to those endemic communities. So water, water, water. Certainly, you are talking also to the health sector. And so for those of us in the health sector, we think there's need for proper mapping of the water needs of this country. Because in some areas, you actually have water, but the water may be brackish. In which case, for you to use that particular water for drinking purposes, for domestic use, you must do desalination.
The representative of the Egyptian Prime Minister and President of African Ministerial Council on Water, Mohammed Baha Eldin, said the Nigerian government had taken the right step in its special attention to water. In his words, his organization, AMCAO, appreciated every bit of the action Abuja had adopted toward water.
It is our honorable President Johnathan that signed the ratification of hosting agreement in 2010. We are indeed grateful to Your Excellency and Nigerian people for excellent hosting that we have continued to enjoy. Finally, Your Excellency Mr. President and my colleagues, the Minister and Dynamic from CAO Vice President for this initiative, I have no doubt that this summit will come up with dynamic African homegrown solutions needed to create an enabling environment for sustainable financing of water sector for this great country, Nigeria.
Niger State Governor Taliban Mina Babangida Aliyu, who spoke on behalf of the Governor's Forum, said the activities of donor agencies should be harnessed even as government strives to live up to its obligations to the people in the provision of water. The bottom line for Governor Aliyu was the need for an institutionalized framework by which people could even go to court when they feel they have been denied water.
Because part of the problem again is the capacity of those who are to implement whatever policy you come with. Many a times you find that the people who will implement may not even appreciate the difficulties and the problems and the challenges that are involved in the matter. And at the end of the day, what they will be doing is looking only at the money that they will expend, not necessarily the goals that will be achieved. It will also help us to mobilize the beneficiaries. Should water be free, or should we ask people to pay for the services? Many of our states, the country, we have no problem with the actual volume of water, but it is the delivery of the potable water to the people that is very crucial.
When the Nigerian Senate President David Mark took the floor, he reminded everyone that a growth in population would demand a proportional increase in water supply, and that the authorities owed the people the duty of providing potable water at all times. Senator Mark said the Nigerian legislature would work with the federal government to provide the enabling laws on water supply.
Access to water, potable and affordable water, therefore, is a God-given right. Overcoming the numerous challenges that we face in Nigeria with regards to water delivery means that a collective approach is needed. This should bring together all tiers of government, the federal, the state, and the local governments, as well as the private sector participants and the support from our development partners. As with other sectors, success in this area can only be achieved through public-private sector partnership. However, this has to be done within a balanced regulatory framework so as to protect the rights of the poor.
Since the summit was on innovative ways to fund water supply in Nigeria, quite a number of suggestions came up at the meeting. While there was seeming consensus on huge funds to drive water development, there was still a note of caution on keeping water within the reach of the ordinary Nigerian. Some children and teenagers built compulsion into the duty of providing good and adequate water when, at the end of their drama sketch, they turn to the high table to make a plea.
For us at the ministry, we are committed. There's no going back. We reform the water sector in Nigeria, open up the space, states should participate, have a better structure between federal and states. What does federal do? What do states do? Where can private sector come in? What kind of limits can we put on the private sector to ensure that quality is maintained and have a proper approach? So to know that there's a social dimension to it. So the people who are in the lower income brackets don't suffer. They can still be able to grow, and the quality of services in those areas can still improve. There's a future, and I think let us watch out and see how it goes on.
The presidential summit on innovative ways of funding the water sector was a two-day affair. Beyond the opening ceremony, there were panel discussions. Please watch out for yet another part of the summit in the subsequent episode.
Well, viewers, I'd never seen a summit that had been so well attended as this. The government of the day have demonstrated a huge sense of goodwill and commitment. And that explains why the president, Dr. Goodluck Johnathan, did not just come with his vice president. The Senate president was there. The former president, President Olusegun Obasanjo, even the former president of Ghana, and a lot of other countries here represented. I've learned some new things here today. I'm glad I came. And time would not permit us to give you everything today. But next week is another date. Make sure you join us then. The focus is still on the water sector and finding innovative ways of funding this very, very vital sector. I remain your anchor on Motayo Motisho. God bless you. See you next week. Make it a date.